The Philippines approved some $640 billion worth of investments from January to May. The government says this was higher by 14% last year. Local investors chipped in most of the overall figure at 525 billion pesos. Foreign sources, meanwhile, accounted for 114 billion. Countries with the biggest source of investments were Switzerland, the Netherlands, as well as Singapore, China, Taiwan, and the U.S. The government expects these to generate 13,000 jobs. It also says majority of the projects to be funded by these will go to renewable energy, agriculture, as well as real estate, among others. The Maritime Industry Authority, or MARINA, is the latest Philippine government agency to fall victim to a cyber attack. It announced four of its web-based systems were attacked and compromised over the weekend. MARINA adds it is working with the Information and Communications Technology Department to investigate the breach and mitigate the potential impact of unauthorized access to private information. This is the latest in a string of cyber attacks against Philippine government agencies. Last month, a data breach affected the firearms database of the Philippine National Police.
Interesting findings by Reuters today. Its 2024 digital news report says adult Filipinos are now relying less on traditional social media platforms to get their news. Reuters' latest DNR found an 11% decrease in Filipinos turning to Meta's Facebook for news from the 72% last year. This drop was also seen in other major social media platforms, YouTube and formerly Twitter, X. In contrast, the report found TikTok slightly gained ground as a source of news among Filipinos. The Reuters study says the change in news consumption habits was helped in part by video networks and private messaging apps, offering more personalized news experiences. It also notes legacy platforms have shifted their focus on content creation and other types of engagement from news publishing.
Ships of the Philippines and China have reportedly collided near the Spratly Islands in the disputed South China Sea. In a statement, Beijing's Coast Guard said a Philippine replenishment ship ignored warning from the Chinese side and approached the Chinese vessel in an unprofessional manner, resulting in a slight collision. It also accused the ship of having broken into the sea near the Ayungin Shoal, forcing China to take control measures in accordance with the law. The Philippine Coast Guard has yet to issue a comment on the report, but the Armed Forces of the Philippines says it will not discuss operational details of the legal humanitarian mission at Ayungin Shoal, which is well within Manila's exclusive economic zone. The AFP adds it will not dignify the deceptive and misleading claims of the Chinese Coast Guard. Beijing claims almost the entirety of the South China Sea, brushing aside competing claims from several Southeast Asian nations, including the Philippines, and an international ruling that has invalidated its claims. Several initiatives are announced by Australia and China to mend frayed ties. Beijing's Premier Li Qiang met Monday with Australian Prime Minister Anthony Albanese in Canberra. The latest efforts include China bringing in Australia to its visa waiver program. Deals were also signed for cooperation on trade and military communication, among others. Beijing's top two officials is the first Chinese premier to visit Australia in 7 years. Now, ties between the two nations soured in recent years over the COVID-19 pandemic's origins and amid wider security tensions in the region. In that period, China moved to block some $20 billion worth of Australian exports to the country.
Australia advocates that we should all work together to promote a regional balance where no country dominates and no country is dominated. A region where countries large and small operate by the same rules that we have all had a say in shaping. I've made it clear as nations with different histories, political systems and values, we will cooperate with China where we can, disagree where we must, and engage in the national interest.